Hello, with Annette here. Welcome to another of my videos about movie production gone wrong. Lawrence of Arabia. This 1962 drama was directed by David Lean, and is based on Thomas Edward Lawrence, who wrote a book about his adventures titled Seven Pillars of Wisdom, which was published in 1927. The story depicts Thomas's life as it became divided between the British alliances and his newfound comrades during World War I, when the Ottoman Empire was at its height around the Hejaz province and Greater Syria. The movie also depicts Thomas's involvement with the Arab National Council and the attacks on Aqaba and Damascus. Peter O'Toole, who was hired to play the role of Thomas Edward Lawrence, was taller than the actual man, which led to many controversial debates among the critics. My thought though, down to the height, at least the camera was able to view the main character better. Thomas was a private man in real life and despised his photograph being taken too. The only way people were able to take a picture of Thomas was by tricking him, but later Thomas agreed to pose for photographs to help publicize Lowell Thomas's stage show. In the movie, Thomas is portrayed as being homosexual, but this information is not known as fact. It was only an interpretation of what Richard Aldington wrote in the 1955 Biographical Inquiry, which also interprets Thomas as being an exhibitionist and a pathological liar. Also, this movie depicts that Thomas helped with slaughtering retreating Turkish men during the Tafas massacre, but historian Basil Littlehart disputed this depiction. The movie also left out much information about Thomas being an archaeologist who travelled around Arabia and Syria between 1911 and 1914. During this period, Thomas committed espionage. The movie also does not detail Thomas's negotiations in 1916 to release British prisoners that were held in Kut, Mesopotamia. Due to these mixed details, it caused many biographers and historians to criticize this movie with how Thomas Edward Lawrence is portrayed, as Robert Bolt was hired as screenwriter for this movie due to Michael Wilson quitting in the early stages of production, all because David did not like Michael's political and historical accuracies. Even though this movie was made by an English production company, Horizon Pictures, it was distributed by Columbia Pictures, which was an accomplishment in itself, as many films about Thomas were previously attempted, but failed to get the production moving. The first attempt was made in the 1940s, when Alexander Korda was interested in making the production named after the novel The Seven Pillars of Wisdom, but he had to pull out due to financial difficulties. The Rank organization decided to approach David Lean to direct a version in 1952, but the production failed. While this movie was in pre-production, Terence Rattigan was developing his own version for the stage, which was going to be called Ross. The stage story of Thomas was revolved around Thomas's supposed homosexuality. Ultimately, the production of the stage show fell through, which was highly disappointing for Dirk Bogarde, who had been assigned the main role of Ross. Columbia Pictures had shown interest in the project about Thomas Edward Lawrence since the 1950s. Only reason why the project managed to gain some ground is by Sam Spiegel convincing Arnold Walter Lawrence to sell the rights to The Seven Pillars of Wisdom. With reluctance by Arnold, he eventually sold the right for £22,500. David also watched John Ford's The Searchers to gather ideas on how to film Lawrence of Arabia. Many people can also see the similarities between certain scenes within the two movies. The main photography for this movie started on May 15, 1961 and was completed on September 21, 1962, and Super Panavision technology was used, as it had a spherical lens. The images were in 6-5mm film, which could be printed on a 70mm positive to allow room for the soundtrack. Filmmakers had to do longer takes, and the usage of this ratio caused many camera disturbances, like blurring in many parts of the image. To prevent this, they had to modify a blocking technique which meant more diagonal movements by the actors so the blur could be covered up. The cast and crew members visited many places to film the movie, for the desert scenes alone were filmed in Jordan, Morocco and Spain. Even though David Lean had hoped to do all the filming within Jordan, working Hussein bin Talal had helped to scout out perfect locations for filming, which eventually led to tensions, as the Jordanian officials became annoyed with the uncredited English actor Henry Oscar, who played Sillam, who was a reciter and servant to Prince Faisal. Only thing is, Henry could not read the Quran, and the only reason the production could continue in Jordan was if an imam would be represent to prevent misquotations. David Lean had hoped to film at Thomas Edward Lawrence's favorite archaeology site of Petra, but due to an outbreak of disease that affected many cast and crew members, they were forced to relocate to Spain. The attack on Aqaba was filmed in a dry riverbed of southern Spain's Playa del Algarrobico, the Almería region of Spain, where some filming became delayed due to flash floods, was also the train attack scenes took place, as well as the scene of Gassim's execution. But during the first train attack scene, Peter O'Toole can be seen having his thumb bandaged. This is thought to have occurred during filming of another scene where Peter punched a caravan window while intoxicated. For Thomas's winter quarters in Azraq, they were filmed in the mountain range of Sierra Nevada, Morocco's Wazas 8 was where the massacre of the Tafas were filmed, and many of the Moroccan army were used as extras. However, David Lean became annoyed as he could not film the scenes the way he wished to because the troops were impatient and uncooperative. Robert Bolt had also been arrested during production for participating in an anti-nuclear weapons demonstration, which led many scenes to be filmed with no script. Robert was soon released from prison with the help of Sam Spiegel, who had to persuade Robert to sign a recognizance of good behavior. Peter O'Toole also nearly died during production, when he fell off his camel, during filming the Aqaba scene. Fortunately for Peter, the camel stood over his body to prevent Peter being stomped on by horses that were rode by extras. In 1917, a similar incident occurred with Thomas Edward Lawrence when he fell off a camel. Once production was completed, Lawrence of Arabia won 7 Oscars at the 35th Academy Awards in 1963, which included Best Director and Best Picture. The movie also won the Golden Globe Award for Best Drama Picture, as well as 2 BAFTA Awards for Best Film and Outstanding British Film. Egypt was the only Arab country that widely released this movie, as President Gamal Abdel Nasser appreciated the Arab nationalism depiction within this movie. However, Jordan banned Lawrence of Arabia. Most people regard this movie as the greatest one ever made. In 1991, Lawrence of Arabia became preserved in the United States National Film Registry after being nominated by the Library of Congress for being culturally and historically important. The American Film Institute placed this movie 3rd on the list of 100 greatest American films in 1998. When this list was revised again in 2007, Lawrence of Arabia ranked 7th. The British Film Institute ranked this movie as being the 3rd greatest British film of all time back in 1999. A poll was made by the British newspaper Sunday Telegraph that claimed this movie was the best British-made production of all time. Cape Fear. Directed by John Lee Thompson, this psychological thriller was released on April 12, 1962, which is about an attorney who helped send a criminal to jail, which led him and his family to be stalked by the criminal. James Ruffin Webb wrote the screenplay that was based on John Dan MacDonald's 1957 novel The Executions, which is about Max Cady being court-martialed for brutally raping a 14-year-old girl, and Lieutenant Bowden's testimony was the only evidence the courts went on. The censors stepped in and banned the word rape from the movie, as they did not want the movie to demoralize military personnel. Cornel Wilde acquired the rights to it in 1958 for $30,000. Later Gregory Peck, who played Sam Bowden, owned Melville Productions, bought the rights to the novel, and as Gregory was impressed with John Lee Thompson's previous movies, Gregory decided to hire him as director for this movie. Rod Steiger was highly interested in the role of Max Cady, but he backed out. Telly Savalas was also screen tested for the role of Max Cady too, but Robert Mitchum got the role, and Telly gained a lesser role in the movie by playing Charlie Sivers. John Thompson tried to cast Hayley Mills to play the role of Sam Bowden's daughter Nancy, but due to Hayley's unavailability, the role was assigned to Laurie Martin, and the role of Sam's wife Peggy Bowden was given to Polly Bergen in December 1960, and Cape Fear was the first movie Polly had starred in for 8 years. John Thompson had hoped to film the movie in black and white, but as John Thompson was a large Alfred Hitchcock fan, he added elements of unusual camera angles, close-ups and an eerie musical score. The designer Robert Francis Boyle and editor George Tomasini helped with adding the elements within the movie. The final scene was filmed at Ladd's Marina in Stockton, California, which was a conflict on the houseboat. Max Cady attacks Penny Bowden. The full scene in itself was totally improvised. When Max started to rub eggs on Penny, the reactions were for real. Also, Polly had stated after production that she was in pain for many days after the scene as she suffered back injuries from the violent attacks. Robert Mitchum also cut his hand due to the brawl, and Gregory Peck also had blood on his back. Gregory had also punched Robert so hard that Robert felt the impact a few days later. The fighting scene had got out of control that the film crew had to physically split everyone up to prevent more violence. This movie was later remade in 1991 by Martin Scorsese. Dr. Strangelove, as it is more commonly known, is actually called Dr. Strangelove or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb, was directed by Stanley Kubrick, who also helped produce and write this 1964 black comedy. This movie was made in the United Kingdom, which is loosely based on Peter George's 1958 thriller novel Red Alert. This movie tells a story of a general that is part of the United States Air Force that commands a B-52 plane to bomb the Soviet Union with nuclear bombs. The President of the United States and the Royal Air Force do everything in their power to prevent a nuclear world war. Stanley Kubrick originally intended this movie to be a drama, as he had a vague idea to base the movie around the Cold War. Stanley Kubrick read the novel Red Alert as suggested by the head of the Institute for Strategic Studies, Alistair Buchan. Stanley Kubrick hired Terry Southern to co-write in 1962. Stanley Kubrick's changed his mind to turn the movie into a black comedy after reading the novel The Magic Christian, which was a gift from Peter Sellers, which Peter Sellers had three roles to play within the movie. Peter Sellers played the Royal Air Force's group captain Lionel Mandrake. Peter Sellers also played the President of the United States, Merkin Muffley. Peter Sellers also played the leading role of Dr. Strangelove. Peter Sellers was also set to play a fourth role of Major T.J. Kong, but due to an ankle injury that led him to be in a wheelchair, the role of Major T.J. Kong was given to Slim Pickens. There were many titles that were thought of by Stanley Kubrick: Dr. Doomsday or How to Start World War III Without Even Trying was one, Dr. Strangelove's Secret Uses of Uranus was another, along with Wonderful Bomb. As Peter Sellers was going through a divorce during the time of production, he was unable to leave England, so the filming took place at Shepperton Studios near London. This movie was set to be screened on November 22, 1963, which was the same day President John F. Kennedy was assassinated in Dallas, Texas, and the movie was set to premiere just weeks later. Due to the unfortunate events in Dallas, the release was delayed until January 1964. One particular line Slim Pickens had to say mentioned Dallas, which was changed to Vegas. However, Dallas is still mentioned in the French subtitled version of the movie. The final scene should have been a pie fight, which was taken out of the movie. It is uncertain why. Couple of possible reasons why they did so, one being that it would have been seen as offensive to the family of John F. Kennedy, another is the cast were laughing too much during the pie fight scene and it did not coerce with rest of the movie. This movie is known for being a best comedy. The American Film Institute ranked Dr. Strangelove 26th in its list of best American movies in 1998. Then back in 2007, the movie was ranked 39th. Dr. Strangelove was the first of 25 movies selected for preservation in the National Film Registry by the United States Library of Congress back in 1989 for being culturally and historically important. The War Lover. Philip Leacock directed this 1962 British war movie, which is based on John Hers's 1959 novel that shares the same title. This movie does not focus on the war but more Captain Buzz Rixon, who is played by Steve McQueen, who goes around antagonizing everyone to achieve what he wants. This movie was filmed at Shepperton Studios as well as around Cambridgeshire, including King's College. R.A.F. Bovingdon and R.A.F. Manston were also locations that filming took place. Shirley Ann Field, who played Daphne, turned down the chance to travel to Hollywood to be in this movie. One B-17G plane and two Coast Guard PB-1W aircrafts were converted to look like three B-17 Flying Fortress bombers. One of the pilots, Martin Caldin, wrote a novel, Everything But the Flak, which is based on the transatlantic crossing the planes had to take for this movie. Mike Riley was the stunt double for Robert Wagner, who played Ed Bolland. Mike Riley was all set for his parachute jump over the English Channel. Unfortunately for Mike Riley, something went wrong, which caused him to lose his life in the waters below. As this movie was filmed in black and white, Sony Pictures decided to colorize the movie back in 2003, however, this color picture never made it to video. The Horror of Party Beach. This 1964 horror movie was directed by Del Tenney and is classed as being the worst movie of all time. Del Tenney began his career in acting as he appeared as an extra in numerous movies. The producer Alan Isling approached Del Tenney. They both contributed $50,000 to make this movie, which was filmed in black and white. The location for filming was the Atlantic Coast and Chippan Point area of Stamford. The Charter Oak Motorcycle Club were hired to play a bike group within the movie, but during a bike and car chase, one of the members of Charter Oak wanted more piece of the action and sped to the front, and collided with John Scott, who played the gang leader Hank Green. This caused a pile-up, many riders and John Scott was injured. The police car that was on the way to the scene also had a crash of its own. Thank you for listening. If you like my content, please like and subscribe. To keep up to date with future videos, then press that notification bell, alternatively follow me on Twitter @withanet1.